Hi Rutvika, how are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Thank you. Can you tell us your background?
Yeah, I started badminton when I was seven years old.
Okay, that's cool. So
I was not professional first, but my father used to play with his friends. So even I went, I just had fun with them. But gradually, my coach came over there. Prem Singh sir,
okay.
And he saw me playing, he told my father, he asked me to join me and I played. And gradually I became a professional player.
Wow, that's really cool. I mean, can you tell us about your coach?
Yeah, my first coach is Mr. Prem Singh sir, and then he was just for a year or something like that. Then Mr. Sudhakar Reddy sir, who was working in SAP Academy in Kamala, and then now it's Gopi sir. It's been 2 years almost I joined here, and Gopi sir is simply superb.
So when did you think that you can actually play for India? So what made you think like that?
Yeah, when I won the first under 10 title at Cochin, then I was like, I have to play for India. I can do it.
Wow, that's superb. And can you please share some memorable moments in the junior circuit in which you won almost 80 medals in various groups till now, and what do these victories mean to you?
Yeah, there are so many memorable victories. Like I won all the junior titles, like under 13 singles and doubles, 15 singles and doubles, then 17, 19, all the events I won. So I can remember all those matches really.
Superb. You played some senior tournaments too. How big is the leap from juniors to seniors? And is it more physical or do you think it's mental?
No, playing with seniors is really fun. No, you don't feel any pressure and then you play very freely.
What is your biggest accomplishment in your sport, and what would you think is the ultimate achievement?
I think tournaments like All England or a Super Series, an Olympic medal.
Okay, what do you think is the biggest accomplishment till today?
Winning junior nationals at Imphal, winning 17 singles, 19 singles and doubles.
Wow, superb. What's the parents' role of yours when you're emerging as a player?
They work really hard, like they used to come wherever I go, leave their business, leave home, leave my brother at home alone.
Yeah.
And they used to come wherever I go. Now I just send them. I can go, it's okay.
Sure, that's really cool. And what's your daily routine? What time do you wake up?
Yep. And then study, morning 4:30. We get up, we do session, then again 7 o'clock session. Then again at 10 or 11.
Okay.
Then evening 4 o'clock to 6:30, something like that.
This is interesting. How do you prepare yourself and before a game, and how important it is to visualize the sport before you start playing?
Before a match, actually we need to take rest properly, eat food properly, and go to the stadium an hour before, just listen to music and then start warming up.
Yeah.
Night we have to sleep well. After some 20 minutes, then after warming up, 20 minutes, then I go talk to my coach how to play.
Okay.
Then if I have the video of like how the player plays in the before matches, then I check those videos.
Okay. When you reach the top level in your sport, everyone are at the same level. So whoever is mentally strong would be able to handle the pressure. So is that the same way for you as well? Do you prepare mentally, physically, and then go?
Yeah, mentally to be strong is really important. And I need to talk to coaches before that.
Okay.
Then only I'll be strong mentally. I don't know, since childhood I love it.
Wow. Who are your idealizing sports icons?
Sports icons? I think Saina. Really superb. I can't say anything else.
Yeah.
She practices here daily with us and we feel proud of her.
It must be everybody's dream. So what's your opinion on IBL?
IBL is a wonderful event. Got successful last year. That was the first year. So
yeah,
it has a good future.
How do you set your goals and what are your long-term and short-term goals for today?
Basing on how I play, I set my goals. The short-term goals are, first I have to play well in the senior circuit, and then long-term, then I'll do it.
Okay. How do you celebrate your victories?
Celebrate victories? I don't like to celebrate so much. I call my parents, I talk to them for hours and hours. And I just celebrate it for the day.
Okay. The day you won that,
yeah,
title. Okay.
And after that, I just forget that, because I need to forget. How else?
Yeah. So, just in case if there's a tough loss that particular day, how much time do you generally take to come out of it?
It's just a day, because I have to forget winning or losing, I have to forget first.
Okay, you forget the winning also.
Yeah.
That's brilliant. What is your daily diet and how much importance is it to give you proper fitness?
The daily diet is decided by Gopi sir. He makes all the, he decides what all you have to eat, and he keeps on talking to us about what you have to eat and all, and he changes the menu every 2 months or something. He keeps on telling us you should not eat so much of sugar, you should not eat chocolate.
Okay.
So then we eat more of sprouts,
mm-hmm,
boiled vegetables, boiled things.
Players do have ups and downs, you all know that, right?
Yeah.
So where do you draw the inspiration when you're actually down?
I just talk to my coaches of what mistakes I did in the match. Then they keep on telling me like this, you did like this. And then we come back, we do all those training,
okay,
what we have to do for that. And slowly I'll forget it. I keep on working hard on that because I remember the match, I lose it.
Yeah. Who's your favorite sports star?
In badminton or any other sports?
It's up to you. You can answer.
Sachin Tendulkar.
Wow. And did you have any injuries in your career?
I don't have big injuries. I have a small injury.
Okay.
I have an ankle problem. That's in recent times.
Fair.
In senior nationals, I was playing with the Saidi Rani, and then I fell down and I twisted. So that's the injury. That's all. I don't have any injuries.
So how do you deal with the injuries? You're fine now?
Yeah, I'm fine now. There's a physio, so he takes care of us.
Oh, cool. How much does your equipment cost, and what would be your monthly expenses for all the coaching and equipment? What all do you carry to a tournament?
Monthly expenses will be around 15,000 or something like that, because I have to pay in the academy, then we go out and all.
Yeah.
Equipment will be 10,000 per month, no more than 5 to 7,000 per month, and we get kitting from Yonex, so we are sponsored by Yonex, so
okay,
we don't have to buy all the equipments, they send us.
What do you recommend for the people living in small places? How should they pursue their passion of being a sports person?
The people who are staying in normal villages, they should play sports. Even they should know how we play. They should just come and watch at least. Should get an opportunity to see how we play, train, and they should be inspired by that. And then even they should start playing. And over there, I don't think they get to play, but they have to come here. Somebody should be there to tell them.
Hopefully, we would do that in the near future. Thank you. And we wish all the success for all your future tournaments, and hope you bring lots of results for the country. And thank you so much for your time today.